Here are 20 plus tips for the latest version of macOS Sequoia 15.1. You can now drag and drop files with iPhone mirroring, powerful camera and background tools built right into the control center, settings for window snapping and shortcuts, and the one feature I was wanting from Apple Passwords, it's already built in, I just didn't see the checkbox. All right, first up, let's talk about iPhone mirroring, because now in 15.1, the latest update, you can now drag and drop files from your Mac to your iPhone right here in the iPhone mirroring window. Let's go over to the Files app here on my Mac. I can just take an image here in the Finder on my Mac, drag it into the iPhone mirroring window, and you'll see it just transfer right over. It doesn't work for third-party apps just yet, so like if I try to drag a video file into something like Instagram, it won't copy over, so you need to copy it into the Files or Photos app first, and then you can upload it here in the iPhone mirroring window. Tip number two, I don't get a lot of notifications, but you can actually reply to them here on your Mac, even if they're coming in from your iPhone notifications. You just click reply up there in the notification center on your Mac, and type it out, hit enter, and you're good to go. But tip number three, which I didn't realize, there's actually keyboard shortcuts for going to the home screen, searching, and the task switcher all on the iPhone. They're actually up here in the menu bar. If you go to the View menu, you'll see Command 1, 2, and 3 for Home Screen, App Switcher, and Spotlight. But now you can go quickly to the App Switcher or go directly to Spotlight and start searching, or Command 1 to go home. Makes navigating the iPhone mirroring a little easier. And tip number four, speaking about those notifications from your phone to your Mac, you can actually customize what apps will come over. So if I go to the Apple icon here and go to System Settings, then if I go down to Notifications, you'll actually see at the top, Allow Notifications from iPhone, that's for that iPhone mirroring, and here you can toggle on or off what apps you want to be able to send notifications to your Mac. And tip number five, you can also turn on or off sounds from notifications, specifically from the iPhone, or if you just want to disable them altogether, you can uncheck this box. Also, if you're using the iPhone mirroring a lot and you keep having to authenticate whenever you connect on your Mac, go up to the iPhone mirroring here in the menu bar, go to Settings, and then here, rather than ask every time, just choose to automatically authenticate. This way you can just click the iPhone mirroring icon in your dock and you'll automatically get logged in. All right, tip number seven, I moved completely over to Apple Passwords from 1Password, and I found it to be great. I have multiple groups that I share with my family, but one of the features I missed from 1Password was an icon in the menu bar. Well, it turns out this is already a built-in feature, you just have to toggle it on because it's off by default. So when you have the Passwords app open, go up to Passwords, go to Settings, and then this top checkbox right here, just click Show Passwords in Menu Bar. Now, even if I go and quit the app, you'll see the password little key icon here in the menu bar, and you can always go up to authenticate. Then you can search for and access all your passwords, even quickly open up the full window if you'd like. All right, for tips 8, 9, and 10, there's actually some powerful tools in Control Center and the menu bar. First up, you can now do virtual backgrounds built into macOS Sequoia no matter what software you use to record or live stream content. For instance, I'm going to go here to Riverside where I record Primary Technology. My tech video podcast comes out every Thursday. Definitely watch and subscribe. That link's down in the description. But if I go here into my Riverside studio to record, if I wanted to do a virtual background, I can actually use the built-in macOS Sequoia feature for this. If I go up to the menu bar, you'll see this little purple icon here, and then you'll see all the applications that are accessing your camera or microphone. So if I go over to Google Chrome where I have Riverside, you have the portrait effect, which has been there, studio lighting, you can turn on or off reactions, but background is new in macOS Sequoia. And if I click background, I can choose a gradient, you can upload something custom here, or you can choose one of the images. These are basic Apple Guys wallpapers. Shout out to him, links in the video description if you want the Apple Campus wallpapers I'm using here. But I can click the Apple Campus wallpaper and now I'm there. And because this virtual background is built into macOS, you can use it in any video conferencing app, any recording app you would like. And I'm actually using CleanShot X to screen record my Mac right now. And if I wanted to, I could go up here to that same toolbar. You'll see CleanShot X is one of the apps. I can do something called Presenter Display, which will actually put me small in the corner or even large. But I'm actually recording that already with CleanShot X, which is the video source that CleanShot X is using. I can go to background and then you'll see my gradient changes down here in the little circle. Really powerful virtual background tool now built into macOS. All right, this next setting is for battery powered Macs or MacBook Pros or Airs only. But if I go to System Settings here, then I'm going to go down to Battery. And one of the things you can do on the Mac is actually enable low power mode. But there's not an easy way to get to it. It's actually not built into the Control Center. But if I go down to Control Center here in Settings, And then under the battery section, you'll see this show energy mode setting. And instead of when active, I can choose always. And now when I click the battery icon here in the menu bar, low power mode is now an option that I can just enable or disable whenever I'd like, just right here. All right, and this last control center tip, this is not macOS Sequoia specific, but I always forget it and it makes things a lot easier. If I go to the control center and there's ever a control that I want to bring out into the menu bar separately, I can just hold the option key on my Mac, click and drag it into the menu bar, and now that setting is just gonna live here in the menu bar and I don't have to open the control center to get to it. It's still there, my sound settings are there, but now I can have that speaker icon right there, the Wi-Fi icon, whatever you want from control center. Even something like focus mode, I can drag that out. This also applies to something like AirDrop. You can have all of this here in your menu bar just by holding the option button and then dragging them up. And if I want to remove them from the menu bar, I can just hold the command key, click and drag that icon and drag it way down, and it will disappear. Option key to put them in, command key to remove them. All right, next up, let's talk about Safari. In macOS Sequoia, there's new video watching tools. So if I click the little symbol here in the address bar, you'll see Video Viewer is an option. If I click Video Viewer, it's now gonna load Apple's built-in video tools, including things like the AirPlay symbol, making it easy to choose a destination. Yes, I have a few options there here in the house. And you can also click the arrows over here and you'll see Picture-in-Picture is an option. So you can take any video you see while you're watching in Safari and drop it in Picture-in-Picture. Also, if you're in that video viewer mode and you go to a new tab or just scroll over to a new space, it will actually automatically go into picture in picture. So if you just want that to happen quickly, just go to a different tab or change your space. Also in Safari, hide distracting items. You've probably seen it before, but remember you can access it using this button here, and hide distracting items lets you click portions of a website and they will disappear like Thanos. Hit done. And it should retain that change for a website even if you refresh the page. So you see that section is still gone. Great way to hide things like newsletter signups on websites you visit often, just makes it go away. And don't forget, you also have highlights and summaries here built into Safari. So if I click that icon and go to the reader mode for a website, not only do you get the nice reader mode, but you can click summarize. That's an Apple Intelligence feature, and that will give you a 1 or 2 paragraph summary depending how long the website is. But even if you don't have Apple Intelligence, there are many websites that will offer summaries. So if I go to the symbol, you see the little star icon appeared there. I can click it and I'm actually gonna get a summary, which is not necessarily Apple Intelligence. Some websites just have this built in. Even people of interest that might be mentioned on the page, you'll see them popped up here and clicking it brings you to their Wikipedia page. All right, next up, let's look at some settings specifically in macOS Sequoia. Especially if you have Apple Intelligence, which is now in 15.1, you can actually change the keyboard shortcut. So here in settings, if I go to Apple Intelligence and Siri, you'll see keyboard shortcut here, which is specifically for the quote unquote new Siri, at least Apple Intelligence features here. You can either press the command key twice or you can do a customized keyboard shortcut, which you know command space is spotlight. Well, you can do something like option space. So now I can do command space for spotlight or option space for type to Siri there up in the upper right corner. Also, I'm gonna talk about tiling windows in a moment, which is new in macOS Sequoia. But when you tile windows, you'll see if I put that one on the right side, maybe I'll put this one on the left. You'll see there are kind of these gaps in between the windows and the windows and the menu bar. Well, you can change that if you go to settings once again, desktop and dock, scroll down and you'll see the tiled windows have margins. If you toggle that off, you'll see all the margins disappear. Now you can have tiled windows all the way up to the menu bar, all the way down and no space in between. Also, while you're here, you can do the double click a window's title bar and change the functionality. So if you want to make it minimize, I can double click a title bar and that window will minimize. And then double clicking the title bar will fill the space. Or I can go all the way up to fill and it will just completely fill the screen, but not full screen, so you still see the menu bar. Double click again. Personally, I keep it on the minimize setting. So let's get to that window tiling. Again, that's new in macOS Sequoia. For any window you have open on your Mac, click and hold on the green dot in the top left corner and you'll see some of the move and resize options. For instance, maybe I want this to be the right 50%. Well, I can let go and now that window will snap to the right 50. But you can also hold the option key on your keyboard. And now when you drag a window by the title bar, you'll see some options here, whether to go left or right, and it will automatically snap to that position. Take this window, hold the option key, and then I can snap that 50-50. The third option, of course, is to go up to the window menu here, and then the move and resize options. And you actually have more options here than you do when you click and hold on a little green go light. So you can also do top right, you can do quarters, and you can even return to previous size. and you'll see all the keyboard shortcuts that you have here as well. Well, if there's one that you'd like to use pretty often, maybe you just really love putting it in the top right or bottom right corner. Well, remember, we could do a keyboard shortcut if we know the exact phrase of that menu command. So bottom right, I'm going to go back here to the Apple icon, System Settings, let's go down to Keyboard, and then we'll go to Keyboard Shortcuts, App Shortcuts down here. We want this to be under All Applications, so when I click plus, I'm going to leave this as All Applications. I've actually already forgotten what it said, so let's go back up to Window, and we're going for Top Right. Let's do Top Right. And then customize your own keyboard shortcut. I like doing the 4-button keyboard shortcuts because I don't have too many of them, so it should be open. So I'm going to do Shift Option Command R, and that should make any window go to the top right corner. I'll exit the settings. Let's go back to the Safari window. I'll do my keyboard shortcut, and now we can have that automatically available to us with that keyboard shortcut for any app, any window. All right, here in the home stretch, let's look at the calculator on the Mac. There's actually some more options here. By clicking this bottom left icon, you can go into scientific calculator mode or even programmer calculator mode. I don't even know what you do with that. Or you can go to the math notes mode, which will actually just open a note, and you can do math in notes. We'll stick with the scientific view for now, but you can also go up to the view option here and then to convert, and this will open up a conversion tool. And you can change this to currency, to weights, to measures, even things like data. And so if we want to do currency, USD to European, now I can write in a number and it's just to automatically convert. I can swap it here, and that's an awesome built-in feature now of the calculator. And Option Command C will turn on or off those conversion tools. Next, if you use your Mac maybe with an entertainment center, I'm going to be doing that with my new M4 Mac Mini, but if we go to the Apple TV app here on our Mac, I'm going to go up to TV here in the menu bar and then Settings, and then if we go over to Playback, you'll see streaming options. I want that up to 4K. Unfortunately, your download options are only 1080p, which is kind of unfortunate. But here you'll also see HDMI pass-through. And so if you have this connected to maybe a home theater receiver and you want that Dolby Atmos audio to come through all the way to your system, go ahead and prefer HDMI pass-through. And now you should get that Dolby Atmos if you have your Mac connected via HDMI. Let's look at the Finder real quick, because if you use iCloud Drive, you'll know that some files will automatically be removed from your Mac to save up space, and you'll have to re-download it again. That's what these little symbols are. Well, now I can right-click a file, and there's a Keep Downloaded option, which will mean that file will always be local on my device, even if I'm filling up my hard drive. You can also do that for entire folders, so I can right-click a folder and Keep Downloaded, and you'd never have to worry about those files being offloaded, and then you need them in a pinch. Finally, I've talked about this in my iOS 18 videos, which I'll link above, but you can go to your focus modes here on your Mac, and if you have Apple Intelligence, so an M series Mac or higher, now when you go down to the focus modes here in Settings, there is that Reduce Interruptions focus mode. It's built in. It will just try to intelligently figure out who or what apps need to break through your focus mode. And you can enable that here in the Control Center as well by going over to Focus, and you'll see the Reduce Interruptions focus mode right there. And finally, there is a cool retro Mac wallpaper now built into macOS Sequoia. So one more time, going to System Settings, down to Wallpaper, and you can choose this Macintosh Dynamic Wallpaper, and you see we get the old school green color. You can also choose, if you want to customize that, maybe to the accent color or maybe purple. Nice little animation, it kind of pulls up from the bottom. You can choose automatic, light, or dark themed, and just a pretty cool Easter egg there. So those are over 20 tips for macOS Sequoia 15.1 and higher. Let me know if you have any questions in the comments below. And as we get more software updates, including more Apple Intelligence features, I'm going to cover right here on the channel. So be sure to subscribe and hit that like button. And if you want to see the Apple Intelligence features in 18.2, including Genmoji, Image Playgrounds, and the ChatGPT integration, you can check out my video right up here. Or if you're interested in visual intelligence and how that's going to work on the iPhone 16 with camera control, I did an entire video on that as well. You can check it out right up here. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.